Hey, you know, nursery time is great because we learn to work and play and get to go on adventures. We sing, we pray, we're growing every day. You'll learn to read, you'll learn to write, you'll learn to name your shapes and count right. And I say, hey, you know, nursery time is great because we learn to work and play and get to go on adventures. Great to see you, let's learn new ways about all the things from nursery days. Come, we'll enjoy what each new day brings. And I say, hey, you know, nursery time is great because we learn, work, and play and get to go on adventures. And I say, hey!
Hello, boys and girls. I trust that you had an enjoyable weekend. Welcome to Nursery Learning Adventures. My name is Teacher Nicole. What's yours? Hello, Bianca. Hi, Malachi. Good morning, Indra. Hello, Anil. Thank you all for joining me. I am so happy to have you. We have quite a few things to get done today. So let's get started. Boys and girls, can you tell me how many days make 1 week? You can't remember? Don't worry. Let's sing the Days of the Week song and maybe that will help you to remember.
7 days in a week, 7 days in a week, 7 days in a week, 7 days make 1 week. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
That's right, boys and girls. There are 7 days in 1 week. Great! So, let's move over to our daily chart. Can you tell me what day it is? That's right, boys and girls. Today is Monday. So, if today is Monday, let's go back 1 day. What day was yesterday? If you said yesterday was Sunday, you are correct. Listen carefully now. If yesterday was Sunday and today is Monday, what day will tomorrow be? If you said tomorrow will be Tuesday, then you are correct. Well done, boys and girls. I am super proud of you. Now, it's time for us to look at the weather. I am so excited to know what the weather is at your end. I'll give you some time to check. Did you check? Great. Now here in Georgetown where I am, the weather is sunny and bright. So boys and girls, let's move the arrow on our weather chart to point to the picture that shows sunny. When I get to that picture that shows sunny, you will say, "Stop! It's sunny." What does this picture say? This picture says windy. What does this picture say? This picture says cloudy. What about this picture? What does it say? This picture says rainy. Now, take a good look at this picture. What do you think this picture says? Oh, wow! I heard you, boys and girls. That's right. This picture says sunny. Thank you, boys and girls, for helping me. I had so much fun. I hope you did too. Well, it's now time for us to move over to our concept board.
On we go to the concept board, the concept board, the concept board. On we go to the concept board to see what we'll be learning.
Let's take a quick look at this picture scene. What do you see? Wow! There are houses on a street. Oh, look! At the pretty colors on the house. I can see a number of houses. Can you see them? I hope so. What's that? It's a red car parked in the driveway. Oh my! Look at all the trees and blue skies and white clouds. Isn't it pretty, boys and girls? Yes, it is. Okay, boys and girls, can you guess what is our topic for this week? Don't worry, I will tell you. The picture scene is telling us about the topic for this week, which is my address. So, we are going to be talking all about our address. Pay attention to the discussion, boys and girls. Boys and girls, it is important to know that every house has a lot number. That's right, every house has a lot number. And that lot number is the number that we see written on the houses. Now, our address is made up of the lot number, the name of the street, and the village or area in which we live. For example, Lot 43, Hatfield Street Lodge, Work and Rust. Our address is also used when mails are being sent to our homes. Or if there is an emergency and the fire service or the police needs to find us. The address will guide them in finding us. Yes, boys and girls. So it's important for you to know your address. Now, I'd like you to take some time and find out your address so that in the event of anything, you are able to say exactly where you live. Thank you, boys and girls, very much for listening. I trust that you were able to learn something new today. Now it's time for me to go, and I would like you to pay attention and participate in the next session.
It's literacy time, let's have fun. It's literacy time, let's have fun. It's literacy time, it's literacy time, it's literacy time, let's have fun. It's literacy time, let's have fun. It's literacy time, let's have fun. It's literacy time, it's literacy time, it's literacy time, let's have fun.
Boys and girls, Get ready, it's literacy time. Boys and girls, I am Teacher Nicole, and I will be your year one literacy teacher for this week. I'm super excited for today's lesson, so let's get started. But before we get started, join me in singing the alphabet song.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Now I know my ABC. Next time, won't you sing with me?
Now, we will quickly recap our previous lessons. Last week, we looked at letter A, and we learned that letter A is a vowel, and it says a, a, a. We listened to a story and identified words with the a sound at the beginning and in the middle of words. We also learned to write both uppercase and lowercase letter A. Finally, we identified the number of syllables in different words. Quickly, boys and girls, do you remember our first session? You do? Great! Let's recap it so that we can help our friends who cannot remember. In our first session, we looked at letter T, and we learned that letter T is a consonant, and it says t, t, t. We listened to a story and identified words with the t sound at the beginning and at the end. We also learned to write both uppercase and lowercase letter T. Finally, we also identified the number of syllables in different words. Wow, that was a lot. Thank you for participating. You did well, boys and girls. Now, as we get into today's session, I would like you to lend me your listening ears. Are you ready? Let's go. This week's letter is a consonant, and it makes the sound mm, mm, mm. Boys and girls, I would like you to listen carefully to a short story, which will tell you a little more about the letter of the week. And at the end of it, we will talk about what you heard. The name of the story is Mona from Mucka Mucka. Mona lives in Mucka Mucka. She came to town on a Monday to visit the zoo. She met her friend Mary from Mahaika. They saw monkeys, macaws, manatees, and mango sellers too. Now, boys and girls, let us talk about what you heard. What sound did you hear in the story? That's right, we heard the mmm sound. Boys and girls, can you name some words you heard with the mmm sound? Go right ahead. I'm listening. That's right. We heard the words Mary, mango, manatee, monkeys, Monday. Mahika, Mona, and Macaws. Boys and girls, do you know what letter makes that sound? If you said letter M, then you are correct. Letter M makes the M sound. Uppercase M and lowercase M also says M as in man, mud, mat, mop, mug, monkey. Here we have the M sound at the beginning. Before we move on, boys and girls, did you notice that Mona, Mary, and Mahika begins with uppercase M? Do you know why? All right, I will tell you. If you said it's because Mary and Mona are names of a person, you are correct. And Mahika is the name of a place. Good job, boys and girls. Letter M also says M at the end of these words. Listen carefully, boys and girls. Arm, farm, jam, and mom. Let's make the sound together. M, m, m. Great job. The letter M is a consonant, and it's the 13th letter of the alphabet. Now that we know the letter and its sound, I would like you to keep practicing to make the letter sound. Boys and girls, I'd like you to participate in this exercise. Listen carefully as I call the words. Then you will tell me where you heard the M sound. Are you ready? Mary, man, monkey, macaw, mug, mop. Where do you hear the M sound? Is it at the beginning, in the middle, or at the end of the words? That's right, boys and girls. It is at the beginning of the words. Now, think of some more words that have the M sound at the beginning of the words and say them out loud. I know you can do it, boys and girls. Now, what about these words? Listen carefully again, boys and girls, as you tell me where you heard the M sound. Arm, farm, jam, mom. Where did you hear the M sound? Is it at the beginning, in the middle, or at the end of the words? Take your time and think. That's right, boys and girls. If you said it's at the end, then you are absolutely correct. Now, think of some more words that have the M sound in the middle of the words and say them out loud. Great job, boys and girls. Keep on practicing. Now that we have learned more words with the m sound, let us clap the syllables in some words. You might be wondering, what is a syllable? A syllable is a part of a word, and we can find how many parts a word has by clapping to the beat. Now that we know what a syllable is, I'd like you to participate in this activity. Let me give you an example. The word is man. Let's clap and say the word man. Man. How many times did I clap? One time. That means the word man has one syllable. Let's try it with another word, mug. Let's clap and say the word mug. Mug. How many syllables can we find in that word? That's right, one. You're doing well, boys and girls. Let's try it again. Mona. Let's clap and say the word Mona. Mona. How many times did I clap? Boys and girls, do you know? Yes, I clapped 2 times. So the word Mona has 2 syllables. Okay, let's clap one more word. The word is manatee. Manatee. How many syllables are there in that word? If you said 3, you are absolutely correct. Wow, we have learned a lot about the m sound, the name of the letter and words with its sound at the beginning, in the middle, and at the end. Okay, let's take a few minutes and practice writing the uppercase M. To write the uppercase M, start at the top and make a line down. Then go back to the top and make a line down to the right. Next, make a line up to the right. Now, make one more line down to the bottom. That's the way to write uppercase M. Let's write it again. Start at the top and make a line down. Then go back to the top and make a line down to the right. Next, make a line up to the right. Now make one more line down to the bottom. And that's the way to write uppercase M. Now to write the lowercase M, start in the middle and make a line down. Next, go back up to the middle and back to the bottom. Now go back up to the middle and around to the bottom again. Let's do that one more time. Start in the middle and make a line down. Next, go back up to the middle and back to the bottom. Now go back up to the middle and around to the bottom again. That's the way to write lowercase m. That is how we write uppercase and lowercase m. Make sure to keep practicing the letters. The more you practice, the better you will get at writing the letter M. Okay, boys and girls, let's recap. Today, we talked about the letter M. We learned that the letter M says M, as in man, Mary, Mona, monkey, mug, mop. M also says m at the end of words like farm, arm, jam, mom, and hum. We had fun clapping words and learning how many syllables they have. Finally, we learned a fun way to write uppercase and lowercase M. Boys and girls, it's now time for us to do some work based on what we have learned. Take out your year one literacy worksheets provided by the Ministry of Education and complete week three, day one activity. Have fun completing your activities and take your time. See you next time.
Welcome, boys and girls, to your third math session for the season. I am teacher Marisa. Let's take a few minutes to prepare for our lesson by counting with teacher Monique.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Once I caught a fish alive. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then I let it go again.
Why did you let it go?
Because it bit my finger so.
Which finger did it bite?
This little finger on my right.
Great job counting. Just before we get into our lesson for today, let us recap what we did last week. Last week, we counted two objects. One, two ice cream cones. We learned to write the numeral 2, half around and then across, half around and then across, half around and then across to form the numeral 2. We also spelt the numeral name 2. T-W-O, 2. Now let's listen to a song. And this song will tell us what we are going to be talking about today. So listen carefully.
The wheels on the bus go round and round, round and round, round and round. The wheels on the bus go round and round, all through the town. The wheels on the bus go round and round, round and round, round and round. The wheels on the bus go round and round, all through the town.
Thank you for listening and singing that fun song. Boys and girls, can you guess what our lesson will be about today? A school bus? No, no, no. Wheels? Sort of. The reason I say sort of is today we are going to learn about a special shape that is pretty much a wheel because it is round. A circle. That's right. We are going to be learning about the shape circle. A circle like a wheel is round in shape. Let us sing about the circle. A circle's like a ball, a circle's like a ball. Round and round it never stops, a circle's like a ball. Sing with me, boys and girls. A circle is like a ball, a circle is like a ball. Round and round it never stops, a circle is like a ball. Now you sing. Excellent singing, boys and girls. Now pay attention as I try to make a circle. Start at the top, loop to the floor, swing back around, let's make some more. Look and listen again. Start at the top, loop to the floor, swing back around, let's make some more. It's now your turn to make your circle, boys and girls. Let's go. Start at the top, loop to the floor, swing back around, then make some more. Excellent job, boys and girls. You did it. Now, I need your help. We have to find the picture cards with the shape circle. Point to the picture card which shows a circle. Excellent work, boys and girls. Now that you can identify a circle, take a field trip around your home or classroom. Identify the things that are circular in shape or is shaped like a circle. Awesome! Yes, boys and girls, we have learned about the shape circle. So before we go, let's sing the song we have learned today. A circle's like a ball, a circle's like a ball. Round and round it never stops, a circle is like a ball. Okay, boys and girls, we can now do an activity based on our lesson for today. Go get your crayons and your workbooks provided by the Ministry of Education. And let's complete the activity for week 3, day 1. Boys and girls, take your time and do your best work. Have fun. Bye-bye. See you next time.
Good morning, everybody. And how are you? How are you? How are you? Good morning, everybody. And how are you? Welcome to Learning Adventures.
Hello, boys and girls. And welcome back to another episode of Nursery Learning Adventures. I am Teacher Alicia, and this is your Year 2 Literacy class. I am very happy to be here. We will have some fun learning today. As always, before we begin today's lesson, let us recap what we learned last week. Can you remember what we learned last week? If you remembered, and you said the short vowel sound A that the letter A makes, then you are correct. And I am so very proud of you. Yes, we did the short vowel sound A. And we did some words beginning with the sound A. These are some of the words that we did last week. We did ant, antelope, anteater, avocado, apples, and alligator. We also talked about you and your friend having birthdays, and I asked if you have ever been to a birthday party before and all the fun you must have had there. Also getting a slice of the yummy cake and the party bags to take home. Now, let's jump right into today's lesson. Today, we will be learning about the letter M and the M blends. But first, we will talk about the places that you and your friends can visit. It is always so much fun to travel to different places. Do you agree? But it's even more fun when you visit those places with your friend. A friend going on a trip with you to anywhere is so very exciting. You and your friends can go to the park to play. You can go to the zoo to watch the animals and learn all about them. You can go to the mall or on field trips or to a birthday party together. You can visit so many different places with your friend. But boys and girls, remember, your parents will have to take you because you are still little children. And you cannot go to those places by yourself. You will always need a parent or a guardian to take you to all of those places. Now, let's talk a little about the M blends. In order for us to make the M blends, we have to do something. Does anybody know what we have to do? Can anybody remember? Let's think for a second. When we made the T blends, we added something to it. Do you remember what it was? I think it was the vowels. Do you think it was the vowels too? Yes, we have to add the vowels to make the M blends. Let's make some M blends now. Here we have on our screen the vowels A, E, I, O, U. Now, the letter we are doing is the letter M. And as we know, the letter M is a consonant. Now let's put the letter M in front of all the vowels, just like we did with the letter T. So we will have M in front of A, and we have M-A, ma. M says mm, and A says ah. So we get ma-a. Now we have M in front of E, which will give us M-E. M says mm, and E says eh. Now we have m-eh, m-eh, meh. Now we have M in front of I, which will give us M-I. And M says m, and I says eh, which will give us m-eh, m-eh, meh. Now we have M in front of O, which gives us M-O. M says mm, and O says ah. So we have mm, ah, ma. Now the last one is M in front of U, which gives us M-U. M says mm, and U says ah. Now we have mm, ah, ma. So we have ma, me, me, ma, ma. Let's say that again. Ma, me, me, ma, ma. One more time so that you can learn it. We have ma, me, me, ma, ma. The more you say it, the faster you will learn it. Now, we will try to make words with the blends by adding another letter at the end. First, we have ma. Let's add a letter at the end and see what word we will make. I think I will try the letter T. When we add T at the end of ma, we get ma-at, ma-at, mat. Mat is a piece of material that people place at their door for you to wipe your feet on before you enter their house. Now let's try me. What letter can we add at the end of me to make it a word? Let's try the letter N. Now we have men. The other M blend that we have is me. What letter can we add at the end to make me into a word? How about the letter D? When we add D at the end, we get the word mid. Now we have M-O. What can we add at the end to make it into a word? Let's try the letter P. Now we have m-up, mop, mop. The last one is M-U. What can we add at the end to make it into a word? How about the letter G? We have the word mug, mug. So the words we got when we made the M blends into words are mat, men, mid, mop, and mug. Now I will read a story and I want you to listen carefully for the words mat, men, mid, mop, and mug. The name of the story is The Dirty Mat. The men wiped their feet on the mat. It was dirty. Mom mopped the dirt from the floor. The mop was tall. I was holding my mug. I saw the men wipe their feet on the mat. They did not like the mud. Boys and girls, did you hear the words in that story? Yes? Very good. Well now, boys and girls, we have come to the end of this lesson. Let's recap what we learned today. We learned that it's nice to visit places with your friend. You can go to different places like the park or the zoo. We also learned about the emblems, and we made words with the emblems. And I want to thank you so much for listening. It's time to do some work. Please take out your worksheet provided by the Ministry of Education, Week 3, Day 1. Make sure to do your very best work. Bye until I see you next time.
Welcome, boys and girls, to your Year 2 Math class. I am Teacher Kelly, and I'll be your math teacher for this week. Let's take a few minutes to prepare for our lesson by counting from 1 to 20 with Teacher Monique.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Great job, boys and girls.
Great job counting, boys and girls. Now, let's recap what we did last week by matching the numerals to the amount. How many children are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 children. How many bicycles do you see? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 bicycles. How many toys do you see? 1, 2, 3. 3 toys. How many balls do you see on the screen? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 balls. Great job counting those objects. Last week, we looked at numerals 6 and 7. Let's count from 1 to 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now let's count from 1 to 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, boys and girls, do you know what numeral comes after 7? If you said it, you're correct. Do you know what numeral comes after 8? If you said 9, that's also correct. 9 comes after 8. So this week, we will be looking at numerals 8 and 9. Let's look at numeral 8. First, let's count from 1 to 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's count again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Maybe we can try counting backwards from 8 to 1. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's try that again. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now there are some children on the screen. Let's count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 children. Let's count again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There are 8 children. Boys and girls, did you count the 8 children? Let's count one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Great job counting. Now that we've counted from 1 to 8 and counted 8 objects, it's now time for us to learn the formation of the numeral 8. This is the numeral 8. To write the numeral 8, make an S and do not wait. Go back up. That's an 8. Let's do that again. Make an S and do not wait. Go back up. That's an 8. One more time. Make an S and do not wait. Go back up. And that's an 8. It's time for us to practice writing the numeral 8. And remember, boys and girls, you can say the rhyme as you write numeral 8. Make an S and do not wait. Go back up. That's an 8. Let's do that again. Make an S and do not wait. Go back up. That's an 8. Now you write 8. Great job! Keep practicing writing numeral 8. Let's look at the word 8. Can you see the word on the screen? Let's say the letters. E, I, G, H, T. 8. One more time. E, I, G, H, T, 8. Now, boys and girls, you say the letters on your own. Great job saying those letters in the word 8. Now, let's look at numeral 9. 9 comes after 8. First, let's count from 1 to 9. 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Let's count again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Let's count again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Maybe we can try counting backwards from 9 to 1. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's try that again. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. 3, 2, 1. Now there are some cricket bats on the screen. Let's count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 bats. Let's count again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There are 9 bats. Boys and girls, did you count the 9 bats? Great job counting! Now that we've counted from 1 to 9 and counted 9 objects, it's now time for us to learn the formation of the numeral 9. This is the numeral 9. To write numeral 9, you make a loop and a line. That's the way to make 9. Let's do that again. Make a loop and a line to make numeral 9. One more time. Make a loop and a line to make the numeral 9. It's time for us to practice writing the numeral 9. And remember, boys and girls, you can say the rhyme as you write numeral 9. Make a loop and a line to make the numeral 9. Let's do that again. Make a loop and a line to make the numeral 9. Great job! Keep practicing writing the numeral 9. Now let's look at the word 9. Can you see the word on the screen? Let's say the letters. N, I, N, E, 9. Again, N, I, N, E, 9. One more time. N, I, N, E, 9. Now, boys and girls, you say the letters on your own. Great job saying those letters in the word 9. All right, boys and girls, let's go over what we did today. We counted 8 and 9 objects. Let's count 8 ice creams. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 ice creams. Let's count 9 toys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 toys. We learned to write the numeral 8. Make an S and do not wait. Go back up. That's an 8. We spelt the numeral name 8. E-I-G-H-T. 8. We also learned to write numeral 9. Make a loop and a line to make the numeral 9. And we call the letters in the numeral name 9. N, I, N, E, 9. Okay, boys and girls, now that you know all about numerals 8 and 9, it's time for us to do some activities based on what we learned. So take out your Year 2 numeracy worksheets provided by the Ministry of Education and complete the activity for week 3, day 1. Ensure that you write your name on the lines. Have fun doing those activities and remember to do your best. Goodbye. See you next time.